onze tweede kleine mini-documentaire gaat over Roxette. Zeg je dat wat, Roxette?
Als ik het hoor wel.
Ja. Listen to Your Heart is bijvoorbeeld een bekend nummer van... De zangeres Marie Frederiksson overleed 3 weken geleden. Dat is eigenlijk puur toevallig, want daarvoor, Leo, was jij al op bezoek bij de andere helft van Roxette. Per.
Per is degene die de liedjes schrijft. Ja. En het is 2 weken daarna overlijdt zij. Ja. We hebben speciaal voor een liedje gekozen in het interview waar hij de lead zingt. Omdat ik haar, achteraf bleek ze veel zieker dan dat wij wisten. Omdat ik haar uiteraard niet te spreken kreeg. Maar laten we dit dan maar zien als een mooi laatste eerbetoon aan Marie Frederiksson.
Hello, I'm Per Gessle and this is Stockholm. This is actually the old EMI studio, and this is where we used to record most of the Roxette stuff.
Hey.
Jonas, our lead guitar player, he was sitting there, and we had the drums there. And we did everything here. So it's a magic place for me. She's got
the look. The first album, Pearls of Passion, was made like a band situation. That album was good, but it sounded like dated. And I wanted Roxette to be a little bit more programmed and digital and modern. But there was a little conflict between me and the producer. He wanted to use his favorite musicians. But I was really lucky because our engineer, he actually broke his leg. I'm sorry, Ola. So we got another engineer, which was this amazing programmer and digital guy. So he came into the Roxette project and he and I and Clarence, eventually the producer, we wanted Roxette to go into the computer world. So I bought a new synthesizer, which included a sequencer, and I started to learning how to program that synthesizer. I wrote the look. So this is how I tried to learn how to program this synthesizer. No guitar intro, just this. 3 chords, 1 finger. So it was just like a throwaway, basically, how to learn how to program the synthesizer. So it was written for Marie, that's why I'm singing He's Got The... She liked it a lot, but she said, I can't really sing it because there is no melody. It's just like almost like a rap thing. But then she said that I can sing the na-na-na part, and I can do the answering in the choruses.
Did you like it?
I think it is a hit.
And then of course, when we finished the song, everyone raved about this song. But I was really against releasing it as a single because the whole idea with Roxette was that Marie was going to sing the songs, and I was basically the main songwriter. And the look is sung basically by me, so it didn't really make sense in my world to release that as a single. In the summer of '88, there was this exchange student from America in Sweden, and he became a big Roxette fan, so he moved back to Minneapolis. And there, on his favorite radio show, KDWB, they had this radio show where listeners can call in and ask for their favorite songs, or they can leave their records there if they didn't have the records on the radio station. So he went there and gave them the Look Sharp album. And of course, they hadn't heard about that. And it was lying around there for a couple of weeks, and he went back to pick it up again. They hadn't played it. And fate had it then, when he picked it up, the program director of the station was at the reception. And the program director asked him, that's a really cool album cover, because it looks like a magazine, right? What is it? And he said, this is a Swedish band. Oh, is it good? Yeah, it's amazing. So the program director listened to the first song on the album, and it was, out came the look, and he said, this is an amazing song. And he put it on the air, and you know, as soon as he put it on the air, phones started to ring, and what is this? So they rush released the single, because it was all over the radio, and in 8 weeks, as soon as it was a single, it took 8 weeks to go to number one. Fate was on our side, and it changed our lives for us. Like all northern countries have this great tradition of melodies that's in our DNA. If you listen to classic Swedish old songs from the 19th century, and it's very beautiful, and it's very beautiful melodies, and I think we grew up listening to that kind of music. I think you can hear that in ABBA, for instance, and you can hear it very much in my music as well. That particular Roxette sound that we had created, that was made in this studio in Stockholm with our Swedish people. And EMI in England, the States, they wanted us to move to Los Angeles, or to, at least to New York, or at least London, to be part of the international music scene. But we said no, we don't want to do it, because if we moved to Los Angeles, we would have sounded like Richard Marx, or what was happening at the time in the States. And the unique sound of Roxette, if you listen to Roxette today, it sounds very special from the competition. It's because it was made here, out of Sweden.